Good day to all of you. In the previous class, you have learned about the view option. Let us first revise the last class. Can you tell why we use view? The view option on the writer page helps us in hiding the functions being shown on the page and also to show the functions which have been hidden earlier. Can you tell what is the difference between print layout and web layout? While using print layout, you can see your page in a normal view and you can also see which page you are working on. However, in the web layout, you will only see one page which will be in the large screen. Can you tell how you will remove the drawing toolbar? In order to remove the drawing toolbar, we will first need to click on view and then click on the toolbar options and then you need to click on drawing toolbar. On doing this, the drawing toolbar gets removed. Can you tell why we use find and replace? With the use of find, we can find a word in our document and with the help of replace, we can replace the word with our desired word. Now, all of you power on your computers and open the writer file using the new method taught to you. If you face a problem, then you should carefully watch the video and learn from it. You can open the writer file in many ways. Today you will learn a new method of opening the writer document. This method is the shortcut command method. Are you familiar with shortcut commands? To open a file with a shortcut command, you must know the command for that opening. So first of all, you need to keep your left hand one finger on the Windows key, which is shown in the video, and press the R key. A box opens, which is the run window. In this, you have to, without giving any spaces, type out SWriter. SWRITER. And then take the cursor or the pointer to the OK button and click on OK. Your writer document will open. Let us now know about the options that we will learn today. You will practice using the print layout and web layout today. You will also practice hiding and showing the toolbar and the text boundaries. You will do the same for ruler and then also practice full screen and zoom options. Now, you type out the line being shown to you and copy paste the same 10 times. Remember that each line should be in a new line. In case of any problems, watch the video carefully and learn from it. This video will help us to copy paste our lines 10 times. So, to copy paste the line that you see on your screen, we need to first select the line. You can select it by any of the three methods that have been taught to you. In the video, we are using the mouse or the touchpad and selecting the line with that. You can also use the shift button and the arrow keys. So once you have selected this line by any of the three methods, you need to copy it. To copy the line, we will be using the edit menu from the menu bar. So bring your pointer to the edit menu, left click on that, and then click on copy option. So your line gets copied. You do not see any difference on the writer page, but the line has got copied. Now to paste the line, first click here and then press enter to come to the new line so that your line gets copied on a new line. Now we again take our pointer to the edit menu in the menu bar, click there and then select the paste option. As soon as you select the paste option, the line gets copied. To copy more lines, we have to keep doing this. So if we go to edit menu again and select paste, the line gets copied again. But you notice that since we had not done an enter, it got copied at the same line. So press an enter so that the cursor comes to the new line. Go to edit menu, press on paste option, and the third line gets copied in the new line. Press enter again, go to edit menu, select paste to get another copy of the line. Press enter again, go to edit menu, click on that, and then select and click on paste option to get the fifth line copy. Now for the other copies, let's use the shortcut command for paste, which is Control plus V. So press enter and then do a Control plus V, which means keep your left hand one finger on Control button and with the right hand press V, your line gets copied. Again press enter and do a Control plus V, and this way you can keep copying and all your 10 line or 10 copies are available to you on the writer page. Let us now begin practicing the view menu. So first, go ahead and show how you can hide the formatting toolbar. If you face any problems, then learn with the help of the video. With the help of this video, we will learn how we can hide the formatting toolbar. To hide the formatting toolbar, take your pointer to the view menu of the menu bar. Click on that and from amongst the options in the box, click on toolbars. As soon as you bring your pointer to toolbars, another box opens where the different toolbars are shown. Click on formatting option, and when you click there with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, you will notice that our formatting bar gets hidden. So this way you can hide the formatting bar on your writer page. And next, go ahead and remove the text boundaries. And again, if you have doubts, watch the video and learn from it. This video tells us how we can hide the text boundary on our writer page. In order to hide the text boundaries, you need to take your pointer to the view menu in the menu bar and click on that as is being shown in the video. Once you click, left click on that, a box opens. Now you have to look for the option for text boundaries and left click on this. As soon as you click, you will notice that the text boundaries get hidden. Now, remove the drawing toolbar, and in case you face any difficulties, learn from the video. This video will help us to hide the drawing toolbar. To hide the drawing toolbar, take your pointer to the view option of the menu bar as is being shown in the video and left click on the view option. From the box that opens, select toolbars, and from the other box that opens, click on the drawing toolbar, the drawing option, and you will see that the drawing toolbar gets hidden. Next, bring the non-printing characters on your page. Watch the video in case of a problem. This video will help us to show non-printing characters on our writing page. If we want to see the non-printing characters on the writer page, we need to first bring our pointer or the cursor to the view option in the menu bar. Left click on this option as is being shown in the video and a box opens. Go to the non-printing characters option and select that by clicking. Once you do that, you will see the non-printing character symbols appear on the writer page. Now, hide the standard toolbar, watch the video and learn in case of a problem. In this video, we will learn how we can hide the standard toolbar. Again, take your pointer to the view menu in the menu bar. Select toolbars and then from the box which appears, go to standard option and click on that. You will notice that the standard toolbar gets hidden. Next, show how you can reduce the size of the page, and if you find it difficult, learn from the video. In this video, we will also learn how we can decrease or increase the size of our page. So let's see how we can decrease or make the page smaller on the writer page. To do this, as is being shown in the video, take the pointer to the bottom right side of the screen and press on the minus option. As you keep pressing on the minus option, you will notice that your page size, the writer page size, keeps becoming smaller. So this is how you can make the page size of the writer page smaller. Now, bring back the formatting toolbar and watch the video if there is a doubt. Let us now see how we can show the formatting bar. To do so, bring your pointer to the view menu in the menu bar as is being shown in the video and click on that, left click, come to the toolbar option, click there and you see another box which opens. Go to the formatting option and click on that. When you click, you will see that your formatting bar comes back or appears on the page. Bring back the drawing toolbar and again, in case of a problem, learn from the video. Let us now see how we can get back the drawing toolbar. Once again, take the pointer to the view option in the menu bar, click on toolbars and then click on the drawing option. When you click there, your drawing toolbar will reappear and will be shown as is being shown in the video. Now, remove the non-printing characters. If required, watch and learn from the video. In order to hide the non-printing characters, we will again take our pointer or cursor to the view menu in the menu bar. Do a left click on the view menu and from the box which opens, click on the non-printing characters option. Once you do that, you will notice that the non-printing characters get hidden. Next, bring back the text boundaries. Watch the video if in doubt. To show the text boundary, take your cursor or pointer to the View menu in the menu bar and click on that, and then from the amongst the options, choose text boundaries and select that by clicking. You will notice that the text boundaries reappear or are shown. Now, bring back the standard toolbar. If you face a problem, watch the video to learn from it. Let us now see how we can show the standard toolbar. Again, take your pointer to the View option in the menu bar and go to Toolbars. From there, click on the standard toolbar. This should show your standard toolbar. In case, like in the video, it is not being shown, then bring your pointer here close to the format bar and drag it up or down by keeping the left button pressed. Your standard toolbar will be shown. So this is how you can show the standard toolbar. And now in the end, make your page size 100%. Again, watch the video if you face a problem. Now, we will also see how we can bring our writer page back to 100% size. In order to bring the writer page back to its 100% size, we will use the buttons which are there on the right bottom of our screen. So the plus button, we will bring the pointer there and press till it becomes 100%. 100% is the normal size of the writer page. If you click on the minus sign, you can reduce the page size. If you click on the plus sign, you will increase the page size. So this way, you have learned to show or hide the various features of the writer page. We will end today's class here. So close your file. If you do not close your file, your computer will not shut down properly and it can damage your file, meaning you can lose your file. If in any doubt, watch and learn from the video. In order to close the writer file, so take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad and your file, writer file, gets closed. Properly shut down your system. In today's class, you all revised the sub-menu of the View menu. Print layout and web layout are all examples of sub-menus. You also practiced how to show or hide the toolbar, the text boundaries, ruler, and non-printing characters. You also learned about Zoom. Thank you.